And welcome back to my YouTube channel. So today's video is going to be how to start a YouTube channel in 2020. This is part one of my YouTube tips. There will also be a part two where I share on how to grow your channel. A lot of you guys requested a video like this on where I share my knowledge on how I started a YouTube channel and how to grow one. Obviously, I'm not the biggest YouTuber out there. I'm also still growing, still learning, but I thought it was a nice idea to share the things I already learned and what programs I use, how I edit my thumbnails and all of that. And of course, if you are new here on my channel, don't forget to subscribe and hit that notification bell so you won't miss any new videos. Of course, you can also follow me on Instagram. And now let's get started on how to start a YouTube channel. I wrote some things down on my phone, so if I'm looking down sometimes, then you know what I'm looking at, because I don't want to forget anything, so that's why. So the first tip that I have for you is research before you start a channel. And what I mean by research is what you are doing actually right now. You're watching this video. So learn a little bit on how to start a channel. Also look what videos you like to make on your channel, because of course you don't want to make one day a makeup tutorial and the other day on how to build a car. It has to be a little bit connected with each other, if that makes sense. And to set up a channel is not difficult at all. You just go to Google and you type in that you want to start a channel. And I think you just need a Google account, and then it's quite easy, so that is not difficult at all. If you only want to start a channel to get quick money, don't bother to start a channel then. Because if you want to make money from YouTube, you need to be monetized, and later I will come back to that. But yes, you have to start a channel because you really love it. But yes, you have to start a channel because you like to make videos and you like to share things and you like to be creative, and not because you want to get quick money, because I think then it don't work. And of course, I understand that you like to make some money from YouTube, but in the beginning, that's not the case. And to be honest, I still don't make any money. I'm not monetized yet. So you just have to start because you like it. And to start a YouTube channel, you need, of course, a camera or a phone to film the videos. And to be honest, you just can start with your phone. I did that as well. In the beginning, you don't need to buy an expensive camera, because maybe you just want to try it out and to see if you like it. Of course, if you have the money and you like to invest, of course go for it. If you have the money to buy a nice camera, of course you can do that. But I just started with my phone and it was absolutely fine. The first 1,000 subscribers I hit while filming on my phone, so that's no problem at all. And then of course, if you filmed your video on your phone or on your camera, you need to edit your video. And again, you can do that on your laptop or on your phone itself. So when I filmed my videos on my phone, I hadn't had a laptop that time, so I also edited my videos on my phone. And let me see, the program that I used was PowerDirector, and PowerDirector is free. You also got a paid version, and you got also a free version, but you can just use the free version. So that's how I edited my videos. It was quite easy on my phone, so it's not difficult at all. And there's also a lot of tutorials out there where they show you how to edit. If you are not really handy with editing, you can really learn it on YouTube as well. So you can check videos out where they show you how to edit. And now I'm filming on my camera, and I am using the Canon G7X, and I am really happy with this camera. It's really compact and handy, because I'm also vlogging and I'm also making sit down videos, and for both it works really well. So I really recommend the Canon G7X, and I will link it down below. And I also will link down below the tripod that I'm using. Because I have a camera now and I edit my videos on my laptop and I have a Windows, I am using the program Shotcut. Shotcut you can use, I believe, on all of the Windows, the Apple Apple, you can download it. But if you have a MacBook or something from Apple, you have the editing program iMovie. So if you have an Apple, you can use that for free. And I think a lot of big YouTubers also use iMovie. Other editing programs I would recommend is also DaVinci Resolve. You have again a free and a paid version, and I forgot to mention it, but Shotcut, what I use, is also totally free. And of course I will link it also down below so you can download it. But DaVinci Resolve is also a really nice program, but it's quite a big program, so it doesn't fit, I believe, on all laptops and computers. But that's why I use Shotcut, and Shotcut is also a really easy program to use. So if you are a beginner, it's really great. Then when your video is ready to upload, you of course need to make a thumbnail. A thumbnail is the picture that you can see in front of the video. A thumbnail is so important, because I think if you are scrolling on your phone through videos, the thumbnail needs to speak to you, and that's why you click on it. And of course a title is really important as well, because again, that's the first thing people see. A thumbnail you can make again on your phone or on your laptop. I personally make it on my phone because I find that easier. Any programs that I use are mostly Canva and PicMonkey. They are again both totally free, and they are both also for on your phone and laptop, so you can choose what you find easier. With thumbnails, I would also say find your style. I think a nice looking thumbnail is really important, and I always make sure that my thumbnails are a little bit in the same style. You know, some people like really bold letters, bold colors. Some people only use a picture without any text on it. So just look what speaks to you, what fits of course with your content. So find your way and play with it. If I'm looking back to my first video thumbnail and the thumbnails that I make now, of course there's also a change. So of course it will change with time. Learn of course more, so yeah, it will change definitely, but that's okay. Play with it, have fun with it, and find your style. And if you like to see a video on how I edit my thumbnails, because that's quite a long video I guess, let me know in the comments down below so I can show you everything that I do. On your YouTube channel, you of course also need a banner, and you can also edit that really easily with Canva and PicMonkey. And if you are a beginner, Canva is really easy, because also they have some ready ones, so you only have to change the fonts or the text, what you like, the pictures. So if you are new in editing and in making thumbnails, Canva is really easy for you. Then if you upload a video, make sure you put something in the description box. I always put a little story about myself, what kind of videos I make. I believe you can use 5 or 6 hashtags, so also make sure you use them. And also put your email in there for companies to approach you. And also put a little story in there, what's the video about. So for example, if I make a makeup video, I write down all the products that I use, so it's easier to find back. So I believe I covered all of the basic things on how to start a channel. In my next video, I will tell you guys on how to grow your channel. So I will tell you all of my tips on how to grow a channel and how it works with getting monetized and getting PR packages. So if you like to see that, make sure you subscribe. That video will come up next week, so make sure you subscribe to my channel so you won't miss it. And of course you can also follow me on Instagram, and I hope to see you guys soon in one of my other videos. Bye.